All right, Troy Cooke, solo head coach. You're back coaching after taking a five-year break to coach at Western New Mexico. What's it like being back at Sholo now for you?
You know, I really enjoy the high school atmosphere. You know, it's kind of neat being back. I didn't realize that, you know, I missed it that much. I really enjoyed coaching at college, but it's nice to be back and then being able to coach my own son. When I was coaching at Sholo High School before, he was just a little guy sitting on the bench. And so it's kind of neat to be able to coach him. He's a junior this year, so we'll... And we're going to try to get the program built back up to where it was, and, and that kids are playing hard, and so we hope to get there, but I'm really enjoying it.
Well, your son Cougar had 30 points tonight, tough loss, but just comment about his development, how he's coming along for you.
Yeah, he's coming along really well. He's actually a really good baseball player. He's one of the top shortstop prospects in the state. He's a switch hitting left, bats left and right, and he's a shortstop. And last year he came on as a sophomore and made all region. And so, you know, we have high hopes. We hope that, you know, he can possibly have a choice between playing baseball or basketball at the next level. Yeah, so, but he's really come on. He's become a pure shooter, and he's a very good athlete and competitor, and has a high basketball IQ.
Well, just like you, right? In the multi-sport athlete, you were rodeo. Weren't you in rodeo and you tried to go with the Broncos?
Football, basketball, and ran track and won the state title in the high hurdles. Then actually had a little stunt with the Denver Broncos after I'd played professionally in Europe for a couple years. So, I had a good career and then got into the rodeo thing to stay competitive. And then, you know, this coaching just kind of like the mafia, just pulls you back in. And it's fun. I have a lot of style, kind of similar to Lute Olson. I mean, people have said, hey, you look like Lute on the sideline, you know, and I guess playing for him, you just kind of get that, you know. Yeah. But it's fun. My kids play hard, and I enjoy coaching.
I was going to ask you, Lute just passed not too long ago. How much of an impact did he have for you wanting to get into coaching?
He had a big impact on my life. I mean, you know, and my coaching style. I mean, you know, he was nothing but class. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you won with class, you lost with class, and the character of the players and how you handled yourself. And I mean, he taught me a lot of lessons, and some of them were hard to learn. But, but the style that we played and being prepared and having a team prepared. And there's a lot of Lute Olson in my coaching style.
Yeah, I noticed when I was watching you coach, you're very controlled, mild demeanor. That kind of rubs off on your team, right, to stay focused and at the task at hand, right?
Yeah, I mean, you know, in a tight game, this was a pretty tight ball game, and we just couldn't get over the hump there. But I think, you know, as a coach, if you stay calm, your players stay calm. If you get rattled, they're going to get rattled. And the team tends to buy into what your attitude is and what your demeanor is. And so that's one thing I learned. I mean, you know, all the years playing for Lute, I never heard him cuss. I mean, I he could look at you and you knew that he was mad. You know, you knew when he was mad. He might stomp that foot or something, but you knew he was mad. But, you know, he didn't really just ream you out a lot, you know. Yeah. And I tried to keep that style and try to keep the players motivated and push them to play hard. But it's kind of a tough balance there.
Right. Just one last thing. When you look at Lute's first year, you were on the team. Steve Kerr, Craig McMillan. Well, Craig McMillan came.
Sean Elliott was just coming in after I left, and Pete Williams was there, and Brock Brunkhorst,
But there's some coaches on that, you know, the first couple of years with you and Steve and Craig, coaches up in Santa Rosa, right?
We got a lot of coaches off that team, and I kind of, when I quit playing basketball and my little football career, I kind of got away from the game and just kind of lived life for a while because, you know, basketball had been my whole life, and then it kind of pulled me back in there at the local high school. They heard I was there and offered me the position, and I, you know, crazy enough to take it, and there I was coaching. But I kind of missed out. Now, looking back, you know, hindsight's 20/20, I almost wish I would have just stayed on Lute's staff as a graduate assistant, and I probably would already been a Division I coach somewhere and been fired three times and retired by now. But, you know, here I am at my age still coaching high school basketball and enjoying the game and feel like I'm giving back.
Well, it's great to see you back and with basketball, coaching your son and, you know, bringing up Sholo again like you did before you went to Western New Mexico. So it's great to see you. And I'm sure a lot of people in Tucson recognize your name. And they're going to be very interested to see it, too. So best of luck to you.
Well, thank you so much. And hi to Tucson and everybody. I know I'd like to see some of my old friends sometime. We don't. Yeah. We live up in Sholo, and it's kind of hard to get down here. And my oldest son's actually going to University of Arizona. He's in biomedical engineering, so we're keeping the U of A thing going. And and I know the U of A baseball team has actually been looking at Cougar too. So we might have another Cooke at the U of A playing sports before it's over.
That'd be awesome, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
I noticed he did an Arizona play. Is that after Arizona?
Yeah. It's one of Lute Olsen's plays. We run some.
Okay.
Awesome.
Well, best of luck to you, Troy. I appreciate it.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.